Recording in progress.
All right.
Call the order meeting. Personnel Thought, is there any community input?
No.
No. Okay.
Is that calendar?
I was okay with the nine minutes, but 9-8 minutes, I have a concern about this. Talks about, yeah, good.
No, go ahead.
It talks about, board needs to create remote work policy, which we talked about, then it says to define public availability of tax collector, that was never discussed in the meeting, I don't know how that even got brought up.
Actually, I suggest we hold off on approving this minutes, because I actually had some issues with the 9 minutes that I needed to clarify, but I didn't get a chance to comment on it. So probably what I'll do is I'll just add comments to those, if that's what you want.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll hold on approving those minutes.
Right.
And then you had a few comments on Google too, Paul?
Probably.
I can show you.
All right. I'm not a huge fan of it, so I think down the road, I can give up that system.
I use it all the time.
Do you?
Yeah.
So you're pretty good.
But there's options, I'm sure.
All right, so department heads, you're on fire, I see highway, transfer you into.
Let me just comment on fire.
Okay.
So I mentioned to Sean, I sent an email, I don't know if you saw it, that I thought maybe we should wait on his proposal until we have a secured select board member.
Yeah.
Just to kind of brainstorm through that process. So I did send an email about that, so it's probably not your preference then.
Okay. So highway, George? Hey, John.
How are ya?
Good.
Hey, John. Thanks for coming.
Oh, no problem.
Gretchen.
Yep. Did you have a chance to look at the rules? When do we have to act on this work, by George?
I don't know, I don't want to be crazy, but he might be able to get the caller, yes, you know, he might crack you, so.
Okay.
So now you're like, what is that?
This is the crack ceiling.
Yep.
You go to bring the PO and that would be something.
No, I didn't look at the roads or anything, but.
Okay. I didn't either, and I wanted to do a drive on the ones who proposed for paving as well. In preparation for like the budget workshop meeting, so we can talk about that.
You were closest to me, you know.
Well, that's why I asked George what the timing was like.
The crack ceiling is not gonna change.
Okay.
You know, so we've been putting that off before, it hasn't been done since I've been here, so we need the roads in. We probably ought to think about doing yesterday.
Okay.
And that's not gonna change.
Yep.
You know, the less we can get water in the cracks, the less chance to have heaving and breaking of the roadway.
Okay.
So that's why I brought that up, but we had the extra money, we're not doing all front.
Right, okay. So.
Bonnie Street, Deer Road, Pinch Hill, and Transfer Station. All right, let's just take a look around, just look out on the middle.
We're not meeting in.
Transfer Station, we've all been there, that's cracking a lot at all the joints. And that's been settled and stuff like that, and that is gonna break up if we don't get that sealed too.
Yep.
There was quotes of.
We were doing two weeks ago, I don't know, I think it's something. You like that?
Are you, is it okay that, is it okay waiting 2 more weeks? I mean, if George says that we need to do it, then how can we find? I was kind of curious to see what they were doing, but if we want to move forward with it, it's fine.
We do this as possible.
Yeah.
That's not like the road, you're not, you know, unless we, you know, stop at every little crack in the road, it's gonna be a.
All right, I'm gonna make a motion to approve. PO number 2035, the amount of $7,850, for road maintenance to...
Oh, and your crack seals.
Did you say the crack seals, the Chandler pavement maintenance?
Yeah, Chandler, crack sealing and driveway maintenance, I think.
Okay, second?
All in favor?
Aye.
Can I see that?
Yep, absolutely.
Chandler's pavement maintenance.
I'm sorry, I got it, my bad.
No, no, it's his son, actually.
Oh, okay.
But,
I couldn't, I got it.
I said the land by mistake, it isn't Chandler.
Okay. Okay, great, thank you.
The only PO I have you acted on a signs on the button?
No, we have a public hearing on October 4th.
Okay, because someone questioned, how come you haven't taken the signs up? I didn't know something happened after I left last week, that's why I wanted to double check.
No, nothing happened as actually.
So there's a public hearing scheduled for October 4th in case they ask again?
Is that all of us?
No, just for anybody who's interested in that issue with the Main Street parking.
Anything else for me?
Nope.
No.
One of our trucks is in Manchester, Craig Line, had some warranty stuff, but we have a 5-year unlimited warranty, so we kind of take care of it. Saved the money from the inspection.
What truck is it?
In the one, Craig Line.
Okay.
So they've taken care of checking the things that C and J had found, and said, the truck's got a warranty on it, so it doesn't fix it, so they take care of your warranty item on it, so you won't have to spend any money on it. You know, it's not much stuff like a winter. He told us today that we thought the winter wipers weren't working properly. But there's a, if it's not raining hard, and if you're not using, if the truck's idling, winter wipers aren't gonna work in the typical mode, they're gonna work in intermittent only. And that's what it's doing. But we didn't know there was that option, I guess, because they don't wanna bring out the wiper blades. Because the electric, it's also the electric windshield, so. So that's an option they put in, so they're plunking the windshield on. And they got a couple of gauze clamps that need to be tight or changed, so, and a couple of lights. It's not, nothing serious, but where it's warranty, we'll let them fix it.
Which vehicle is that one?
It's the Craig Line, the last one.
Okay.
Good.
We are going to inspection, so there may be some stuff that comes up for the trucks, so.
Yeah, I don't agree with making a joke, they just, people ask, oh, trucks are coming. And they say they'll come from inspection, but from what they're coming. Expenses we don't know about.
Right, I mean, the pickup truck's gonna need tires before winter, and I got a quote on them today, so it's, but we can decide. I wanna see what they say for inspection first, if they didn't pick up, so before we go to winter. So it's gonna need a front end alignment and tires. Tires you get with them, they last about 2 years, like that, so.
Alright.
One thing that might be helpful, since Jeff and John didn't really know, they, I don't think they get the agenda, so they don't necessarily know if we put something on there. I think it probably makes sense to make sure they get email the agenda before the meeting.
If I didn't ask, I wouldn't know that you wanted to talk about this couple of things.
So we'll try to, I'll make a note to try to remember to do that.
Yeah, I mentioned that to Caroline too, about when they're sending it to you guys, why don't they send it to us where we have email?
Right.
We'll have to figure out more for this one, and it shouldn't just always be the email, but we can get it.
It's fine, I mean, unless it doesn't, there's not a lot on there, it's just making sure, like I feel like it needs to. So it's, I'm gonna share it as a shared document, so if it changes between, say, Sunday and Monday, you guys might want to take a look on Monday. But yeah. Maybe, you know, everything will change on the situation again, but I don't mind doing it.
Perfect, thank you.
Well, I got a call today, they are planning on paving Friday. Now, it's changed 3 times already, so.
Okay.
But they're gonna prep, do all the grinding of the driveways tomorrow, and then the end cuts, so. We'll get that out of the way. I'm not posting that we're closing the road, it's gonna be closed, and the people that don't live, they can go around the block, everybody else will go, if you're on one end, the other 11 end, that's it.
Okay, how are you gonna know if they live there? They don't have.
We've got a pretty good idea.
They don't have many plates.
That would do it.
Just so you know, Kim, I talked to George briefly, coordinating, a neighbor across the street, they got it. Nick's his name, he does a coordinating for Comcast for coming on here. So he coordinated with George, he's got any trees, what trees they're gonna cut. He told me they're not planning on doing a cut until winter of 2022.
Okay.
So like 6 months from now.
Okay.
Yeah, and these trees are scheduled for the first part of January right now, so.
But he said he's had conversations with you before.
Yeah, I'm gonna give him a yell, see what he's, if those are being planned on being cutting, I'll just have him do some other stuff.
Well, and he said, you know, he also said.
That's bringing a crane in for that, so I don't know if they'll have that.
Yeah, and he also said, they probably will, but he also said, quite a few of the trees that are, you know, depends on the property line too. The ones in the site where it's, the wires they can pick down, there's other dead ones that are concerned with the property owners, they're still together, just to okay the property owners to do it.
Yeah, this is way next to power lines and stuff.
Yeah, and this is gonna be one of them. All right.
Okay.
Oh, George, just, you know, sorry.
Okay.
But one of the things I commented on in the emails about bi-weekly meetings again. So we're gonna go back to bi-weeklys after, so this is like the first Monday of the new schedule. So the next one would be the 27th.
No, I think you got it. You might have some workshops, we're gonna have workshops on the 27th.
I may, nothing next weekend?
Nothing next week.
Okay.
Well, budget workshop.
Kevin Cooper, Casey Payment. I'm gonna have him do some patching, but I'm gonna get a quote on with some of the extra money to get a couple of big patches that need to be done, that we're gonna do ourselves. But where he's got the equipment, we can come in one load of pavement instead of, and do it all in one day. Instead of us doing it with five trips to Hot Dog Plant, or I think they trust the people Hot Dog Farm where we don't. So there's a few patches that need to be fixed in different places, so I'll just get one quote for all of them. And it should be money that's within what we discounted from out front, and so still for road maintenance.
Okay, sounds good.
Thanks, George.
Thanks, George.
The lawn would be gone up next.
Yep, thanks.
You can get ready? Yeah, I'm sure.
How are you?
Hey, John, how's it going?
Wonderful.
So. You can make a map.
Sure, yep, so any updates on the security and phone systems?
No, but I just want to make sure we're all clear kind of where I'm coming from. Burns was the last one where I think Sean may have the quote for that. Our phones are from the 1999 or 1998, whenever this building got renovated, and they do not make them anymore. So I just want the board to be aware of that. So they are over 20 years old now, and no longer able to replace them. So the phone system should be updated.
Do you know who was the person?
I believe it was Accutel.
Okay, so we really need to get Ray back in here.
Yeah. But I don't think Ray's probably going to be who we want to go with the cameras at this point. So we actually got very lucky because we really need to upgrade those cameras. We had just last week a employee that was a victim of a hit and run right here in the parking lot. And quite a bit of damage, actually.
Really?
Yeah. And if it had been nighttime, I don't think the camera would have caught the plate. It just caught it as they were. Luckily, they sideswiped just enough that they swung their back end on the way out and were able to grab the plate and find it.
That was Caroline's vehicle?
Employee, yes.
Oh, sorry. She mentioned it.
Yeah.
So.
You only put the bench. You put some guy there.
Yeah, one of our employees got hit, and luckily we were able to solve it within 24 hours, and our camera did catch the plate, but again, barely, and I think it was night, it wouldn't have. Yet if we thought about, as I, Sean and I both talked about putting some, one over here in the front that overlooks the parking lot, and extending the back parking lot, because that's the big problem, is that there's just not enough footage out there for the current, not enough camera footage, I should say. Have employees' vehicles out there, you have four cruisers out there. Really, anyone can do anything they want at any given time, instead of mess with our current cameras and how many we have. So,
did we get an estimate from Burns for this building?
I need to ask Sean.
We did. I think you did.
I didn't see that, I only saw that one from Burns, and it had the fire department, but not this building.
This is what we talked about, that we did it on a...
The fire alarm.
Right, as a deal, together, we got the cheaper.
Yeah.
So I thought, I'll go maybe a...
The last one he sent me, and I reviewed it.
Yep.
The video was only, the video and cameras, and the access card system was just for the fire department. But we don't really need it. For the videos for the fire. I think it was for the access card and, don't quote me, and the video system, I think it was around 22.
What are you looking, what are you looking for fire?
So I think fire is not looking for as extensive as we are, obviously, because they don't have cameras inside the building like we do. We have ones inside our hallway, inside our booking, inside our holding cell.
Yeah.
So, inside our interview room. We have access cards almost at every door in there, so I'll have to get with Sean and see if he has that quote. Ours was more, I know that.
You know what? Yeah. I don't want to say we have to pick and choose, but I'd say it should be more of a choice for police than fire, for the chief, but...
If I...
Well, there's firearms and money in this building.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a thing.
All their engines and everything are inside the building. All our stuff are outside and exposed to the public. There's no fencing or anything to keep them from being damaged. If I had to choose between doing the camera system upgrade and phone, I'd go for the security at this point.
Yeah, I would say that.
So that'd be my first choice.
I would agree with that. I don't see why we have to, I don't know, I have to look at the phones because they're perfectly functional.
Well, and I think Andrea mentioned that they were only a decade old, maybe not all the phones.
They come from the renovation. They were all upgraded then.
Were all the phones in the building were?
Yeah, it's all the same system.
Okay, and we think it's accurate though?
Yes. So, but it may be worth at this point. And we do need to get Ray back in here, but I don't think the cameras that he was offering are what the kind type of burns will, how they will operate.
So are you going to get with Sean about getting a proposal for town hall?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I think he has one.
You know, I was pretty sure he did.
I just saw that.
That may happen. Council hall, I'll double check.
We'll double check. Okay, sounds good.
I know there was two quotes.
Yes. Yeah, and I think with the, unless Ray can come in here and tell me, yeah, this is the exact cameras we use, I think it might be best to bring him in for the phone system, but do something different for the technology wise for the security.
Okay, that sounds good. So, did Will happen to mention the Tri-City homeless issue?
He did, yes.
Can you give us any information about that?
So, right now, there is a, they call it Tent City, and it's technically in Summersworth, but it is right on the Dover line. And it's out on 108, out by the river out there, that little lake. And I know...
You mean Woodland Pond?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was...
Oh, no, we're talking something different. He's talking, let's let him finish because this came in the news recently.
Okay. I thought that's what you were asking. I know we have a separate issue on Kellen.
Yeah.
I thought you were asking about the big one.
Yeah, but I want to hear about that. I'm curious because, good. So I think Dover's in the process of removing.
Well, here's one of the biggest problems they're facing is it's on private land owned by someone. So I know they're working with whoever that is. But the big issue in doing that is when you do this, it's just moving them down the road.
Yeah.
So, where all these people will go, I don't know. But it's a much bigger problem than just homelessness. It's a lack of resources, it's a lack of mental health resources. Just pushing them along doesn't fix the issue at all. I mean, most of these people are good people that just have fallen into bad times and need some resources, and there's just nothing out there for them. Apartments are absolutely skyrocketing with the current market. I mean, there's just nothing out there. You can't rent the one bedroom for under $1,600. So the bigger issue is the lack of resources for these people. So where do they all go?
So, but there's been a, what I've told you, there's been
we have
one gentleman that's lived out there for 6 years plus.
Yes.
and he is very content to be out there. He doesn't make any headaches at all, and he's an ex-military veteran. He does have a few resources he could utilize through there, and he does a lot of them. He is very happy out there, and whenever I go out there, because I do randomly go out there and see what the situation is, and every time he was extremely polite, and just that's where he wants to be, kind of. So
I did speak to one of the residents. I didn't actually get to get out there because I couldn't coordinate it, but I did have a phone conversation with one of the residents, and they have concerns about safety,
right.
Definitely around children, and then people just kind of walking through the neighborhoods.
So this gentleman that you're referring to, he's not that problem. So there's little patches all back there. And this little group that you're talking about are actually very good people that stay themselves. They know where the houses are. They purposely go out this way so they avoid the houses. They come out behind the market basket.
Mm-hmm. These are all beaten trails. I mean,
yeah.
We're talking about.
So, yeah, they all come out that way. They stay away from the residential areas. There's more that are pushed back further into the woods where the power lines are off to the right. If you know where the power lines run straight down, and then off to the right there's a bunch of wood lines back there, and those are the ones that are intended to cut through Kelvin and the backyards and things like that. And we have some of our problems with last winter, I think it was February, I had a call in Chris Perkinson with his canine because we had a drug overdose where someone back there had called his girlfriend and said he had OD'd on heroin, and now he wouldn't answer his phone, but it was on, so we were able to ping it to the general area, and they brought in the K-9, and we were able to find them, and so there's definitely issues back there as well.
Do you know how many people are living back there?
It changes. During summer, it doubles. During the winter, they tend to scatter, and then you get your hardcore group, like the one gentleman that stays there year-round.
So what do you have year-round, maybe 3 or 4 people out there?
I'd say 6 to 7. But during the summer, it could be anywhere upwards of 20. We've had them behind the sled parks, behind the hospital, behind Market Basket, Shaw's, Hannaford. Last fall, we had a fire behind Hannaford.
Was that related to it?
It was. It was a gentleman that, he was one of the ones that gets arrested quite often when we had warrants out for him.
Well, I heard, so, just one last thing. There was a few residents that was one of the things to the guys in the kind of keep a few people off the army or two.
You know? I haven't heard that. I'm not saying that's not true, but I have personally heard that. So, and a lot of them, if you do go out there and say you're on private property, they will move. It's just they move 100 yards down. They're really not leaving the area. So when we kind of scatter them because they have ended up in people's backyards and stuff, we'll find them again a week later. They just will move 100 yards further into the woods.
Yeah, that area is posted, right?
It depends.
Okay.
So.
What does that mean?
Some areas aren't, some areas
exactly.
But it's a town on land?
It's not posted back there, no.
Okay.
Not behind Market Basket, if that's what we're talking about.
But no, we're almost going to have to do a map.
I actually would like to go out, too.
And look here, I mean, yeah. We have to get a map to see, like,
yeah. What we do is we use the GPS maps on our phone. We
have
maps. Because it'll tell you which town line you're in. And that's how summer's worth, and I figured this out a lot of times.
Because the board's real close.
Yeah. It's literally looking at your phone and going, okay, we're in Rollsburg, no, we're in Summersworth.
Do you know if Summersworth has received any calls about this issue?
I don't think they have. I think their main issue is the Tent City that's down by Lone Pond. So I think that's where they're trying to work with Dover and decide how.
So our police force hasn't really received any complaints except for this concern, but you guys haven't really received
right,
complaints.
Right, I don't think we received that. I think it came to you folks.
It did, no, I'm just trying to make sure there's no police.
Nope.
So it's just safety right now, which still a concern.
I want to go back to this. If it were happening at Bicentennial Park, it wouldn't be happening. You know, if it were happening over on Silver Street at our lot there, it wouldn't be happening.
True.
You know, so I got to sympathize with the homeowners. it's a safety issue for them and their kids, and think about their property valuation. Not that, I mean, that should be the most important thing.
And I understand their point of view. It's literally, how do we help these people?
Right.
That's what needs to happen, is how do we find help for these people? Because no one wants to, well, most people don't want to be homeless.
Well, and that's the interesting part, some people want to remain.
Like that one gentleman, he does, that's his little spot, and he loves it.
Yep. Can we move them to Scout Run?
The majority of those folks do not want to be out there.
So.
There's just a lack of resources.
One resident I was talking to, just a concern and stuff, just brought up, but his concern was, what would happen if Dover Summers Road goes back? How big is that tent city you're talking about?
Pretty big.
50?
Somewhere between 30 and 50, I'd say.
So his concern is, what happens if they Dover, if somebody push them out of there, and they're sold?
And they very well could.
And then it becomes a lot different issue, instead of having 20 people, it's just 30 men. When you're talking 50, it's a concern.
So I'm also worried about the liability, and so we had one fire, one overdose up there. Maybe it makes sense to talk to our.
Welfare officers, possibly.
Well, no, the attorney, our attorney, to see what we have for options. And then maybe have a conversation with Summers Road about what they're doing to try to change the landscape over there.
See, my brief opinion is Summers Road really probably isn't even on the radar this year.
That part isn't, right.
Because they got this over here, and there we are. So they, I'm not saying I don't know about it, but my guess is they're not really.
There's so few here compared to over there.
Yeah.
And our people over here are generally pretty quiet.
Plus Summers Road is probably saying, but.
They may have some recommendations for resources as well.
True.
That we can reach out to.
And I know they have that one new warming station that they put over behind Service Credit Union, that little back road in Dover and Summers Road, run that together. But I don't know if it's announced, but we'll have to agree.
So I think just the takeaway is maybe we can do a couple things. One is, you know, we can reach out to the municipal association about what our options are.
Yeah, I can do that.
And then secondarily is maybe we can have a conversation with Summers Road to see if they have some recommendations or resources, since they're dealing with it over at Willetton.
I'm more than happy to bring folks out there.
I would love to go.
They're very nice people, they really are. Again, they don't, most of them don't want to be out there.
Yeah.
So it's very, it's not often we run into one that's an issue.
Can we schedule some time for Chris to go? I mean, I would go myself, but it's probably better if I go with myself, so.
Yeah. I would prefer you go with me.
Okay.
Or one of my officers, anyone.
And not that there's a danger, like I said, I went over there last week, Wednesday morning by myself. Not that I was intimidated, but I was just like, I don't think it's a good idea if I come down, since it's back. You know, it's not right in the backyard.
Yeah.
I stayed a little ways, a few inches.
So one of the residents did offer for me to visit her home, so she could, so I could see from the residential perspective what they're seeing.
Yeah.
I feel, I can do that, but I wouldn't mind.
Yeah, and we haven't had that invite yet, so I'm not sure which resident is or even what they can see. So it may be right on their land, and maybe something we can deal with immediately. But I think if we do ask them to leave, it's just going to push them 100 yards out.
That's right.
It may not take care of the issue of going through backyard and stuff. You know, like I said, it's sort of lack of resources, lack of mental health.
Well, I think probably our numbers are small compared to what Summers Road has to do with. But even still, I just feel like if it was in our backyard, you know, we would want somebody to take some action. And I think right now, we'd start with, you know, kind of reaching out to other people.
It's kind of like the gentleman down there by Cumberland Farms, just over on the main side. He does not want help. South Berwick just kind of let him stay there. He's been there for 2 or 3 years now. He's very content year round to be in that tent.
Right.
So.
And it's probably a similar situation to the man you mentioned.
Yeah, and for the most part, he's very, very quiet. He's harmless. I've gone and eaten slices of pizza from Cumberland Farms multiple times while I've seen him around. Just here you go.
Right.
And he's very thankful, and he does his thing and stays out of people's business.
All right, I'll reach out to you and I'll schedule something. And so you'll reach out to Summer's Work and just see if they have for recommendations and resources.
See what they're doing.
Yeah. All right, sounds good. Thank you.
Absolutely.
That's all I got.
That's all. I didn't have anything.
No fears.
Okay.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
You too.
Force is doing good. We always ask and you guys.
Grayson was made for 2 weeks of the academy, not one peep from them about him, so no news is good news. And new Will's here and good, he started and things are going.
Good.
So I'll be up and up.
All right, great, thank you.
Thanks, Sean.
Town administration, clearing the budget.
Planning board appointment.
Oh, well, actually, let me just comment on the SIP.
Okay.
We did get that from Jim Desch.
Oh, I see.
But, Sally, there's some change in the meeting schedule again. Do you know about that?
No, I don't.
It's.
Because I thought it was Thursday, but then I just heard it was Tuesday now.
Right, Caroline wanted to switch.
So the SIP.
Thursday to Tuesday or the stormwater Tuesday.
So the SIP has been moved to Tuesday. I'm going to guess 6. And that stormwater that I was going to come to after yesterday, when we meet tomorrow, will be moved to Thursday. We're here at 5 tomorrow, right?
Yep.
Been here early. Nobody.
It isn't quite right. So 5 to 5:30 is the rest of the transition discussions. I did send an email to Tia today. And then 5:30 to 6 is the interview.
Yep.
And then and 6 is then 6. Nope. And then 6 is 6. Okay.
And what's at 6? It's
CIP 6 o'clock tomorrow. So based on this email.
All right. So it's going to be only an hour.
Stormwater is Thursday.
Tomorrow's meeting is only an hour.
Half hour. Between the transition and the interviews, yes.
And then I could always go to 6 too.
But doesn't that, I volunteered, so.
Okay.
I didn't know what day it was a volunteer before, but. Okay. So we did get that budget, but I don't have any comments on it yet because I haven't really looked.
No, I haven't either. I saw it come from Josh. That was up yesterday, 2 years ago.
Right.
Okay.
And then the planning board.
And you're talking about the CIP budget?
Yep.
Okay.
The planning board appointment. My issue with that is.
That's also the latest record, like you said.
It didn't come out until Sunday night at like 7:30, 8 o'clock. So we didn't really give. We didn't give them 24 hours to anybody to respond. So I propose we table that appointment. But there's an implication to that, not having that planning board number. You said they don't have a quorum, Nancy?
I don't believe they will unless a select board member steps in or Caroline does steps in.
What's the planning board?
Planning board?
Oh, SIP. Oh, no, planning has because they have extras, but SIP would not have enough people.
Yeah, so planning board, we gotta make an appointment.
Well, I volunteered to be on SIP, though.
But it's the same time as you're going to be here.
No, it's at 6.
Okay.
Yeah, we're all set there, so planning board, we have to make a decision to appoint someone.
I think we
can shelf it, but I don't want to shelf it too long again. If we want to give it a couple more days and see if anybody interested. Obviously no one's interested in Miles should be appointed.
Well, we could make an exception. We could open it up this week and then next Monday.
Yep.
Although we're just doing a budget workshop, we could just make a decision
there.
We're
going to have to.
So I can reach out to Tia and ask her to repost it. It's open until Friday at 5 o'clock.
Right.
Is that okay?
Yep. How else can we get it out there? How that if you want it posted?
Here in post office is usually where it's posted
so
as well.
I can copy a town hall and a post office. stuff is.
And on the website too.
Yeah, the library.
Oh, yeah, that's right too, the library does it as well.
So I'll make a motion that we revise the posting for the planning board permit to open it back up to the public for this week to be closed on Friday at 5:00.
Also.
And.
I'll second.
And then so we'll just plan to quickly address that on Monday at the budget workshop.
Yep, sounds good.
All right, great. Thank you.
And budget workshop's gonna be interesting, it's a lot of things. All right, so.
Maybe more than one.
No, we won't, we're gonna probably do it.
So plan it on.
Facility director on the show for right now, there's really nothing to talk about here so far.
Or update on the portico structural issues, but we haven't yet received an email on the heating contract service.
Okay, well, I have to reach out to. Don't put this in that chat, I'm just discussing it, so I gotta reach out to the civil engineer from, so I haven't seen anything from them about it.
There you go.
Yeah, I wanna put that on my thing to do, we put that in the minutes, that. I got the gentleman's name.
Jay Stevens.
Yes, thank you. I think that's, I was just looking at it too. I guess you're doing things that you go, the first thing that we probably should have thought about before paying. ACC and so on, but, right, you start putting money in the paint net and all of a sudden. So I'll take a little bit of that on that. Will you want to draw on that something?
Okay.
And there's no, you said there's no quote for the plumbing.
Revised, so Caroline did send an email with a revised estimate on the revenue.
Yep.
Oh, I think actually, I think she just sent the spreadsheets.
I got a flurry of emails that came through at like from 4 to like 5:30.
Right.
Probably was a lot.
So I think what was upsetting with the revenue worksheet was that we just needed to agree that it was acceptable with the modifications.
Sorry, is that again, that's all, just a second, I apologize.
So where we left off last week was that she had proposed modifications to the revenue worksheet.
Yep.
And we agreed we would look it over and that we were fine or not fine with that great questions.
Right, and maybe that's interesting.
Yep, she sent it through, so. So I'm fine with her modifications if you wanna, you know, make a motion to let her move forward with adjustments. So I'll make a motion that we accept the revised estimated revenue statement as provided by the town administrator at our last meeting.
And I will second that. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Good, that's one good thing.
So ARPA funds, Caroline was supposed to reach out to Allison about a meeting for that. You know what things from Caroline on that, so I just will table that one.
Well, we might have to reach out to Allison's board.
Okay. Yes.
Sewer water.
This is gonna be the fastest meeting ever.
You know, it's not a bad thing, we're gonna meet tomorrow, I just wanna make sure we cover everything. So fire probably on the agenda.
They really didn't have anything on the agenda, I don't know if they, except for the fire access.
And shots and everything, so that's good.
So board member updates, I don't have anything except I have a highway safety committee meeting on Wednesday. And a city meeting tomorrow.
Okay, I reached out today to Hampton Municipal. I got some information, they have a little bit of like a talent search they can do for a town administrator. They can also posted on their website?
Yeah, they have a classified section.
Which they're gonna do for me, and we're gonna hold a guy down tomorrow, so at least it's out there.
Okay.
Just get the ball rolling on that. They also gave me, I'm gonna talk to them tomorrow, get a little better explanation. This kind of goes into appointed and elected, but it kind of, it's very specific that town clerk is an elected position. And when you read about tax collector, treasurer, and highway, they can be elected and appointed, and it goes in specifically for each one that you're more than welcome to read, but I wanna get just a little information from a lawyer on that.
Yeah.
And just so you know, they're always helping for us to reach out.
Okay.
They're there for us. So that's that, and I do gotta reach out for the engineer for Cortico. And I guess right now, we don't do too much on the plumbing. I know Tom Clark, I need to deal with Tom Clark when the work is done. Is the quote then?
Yeah, no, I think that's pending payment, because we're going to just like evaluate the work.
Alright, so that's something I have to do. I'm gonna reach out, you know, I'll make it a point.
Yeah, once that's done.
I don't think he's expecting to look at town hall and stuff like that, but I don't think that.
Well, yeah.
Should be an issue.
I think if it's maybe half an hour this time, then.
I mean, I can walk through two with them too, and kind of have an idea what's going on, but there may be certain things that just, so I'm good with that.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's see.
And it's nothing to count on, unless you got something for her out there, I guess I'm for that.
I don't. The one thing I do wanna say that isn't on here, in terms of the vacancy, so we got some feedback, and you probably saw it, from Alan Hold about their services.
I saw the feedback, yep.
So what I would recommend is that we, when we turn on the third select board member, we may try to make a decision unanimously on what we're going to do with them if we're gonna use them. So I think we have the information we need. We could have a conversation with Alan if we wanted, but when we get the third person in.
Yes, I agree with that. I also think that my quick opinion of it, it's gonna be a stepping stone position where someone's gonna come in and with the experience, they can come in for maybe a couple months, fill the board into the actual highest. That's what we're looking at.
Oh, an interim?
That's what you're looking at. They're gonna be, they can be placed to high, so they'll do the whole job search and placement?
They will do recruiting. So they have a package,
Yep, that's good.
They have an assistance package, and they'll do recruitment. They also do background checks, and they do all the screening. So they basically narrow it to candidates who are most suited for the position. And so that package is a $3,500 package. If you want to have community involvement in the process, then they add charges for that service. And then they have a comprehensive package that is it's quite a bit more expensive. It's an $8,500 package. I think Alan sent information for both packages.
I'll go through that.
So definitely the recruitment cost, I think, is pretty reasonable. There is no percentage of a salary that you typically might see.
So that's interesting and probably definitely worth to explore. These guys are more just having more of their advertising. And, you know, they kind of will give you a little bit of guidance what you're looking for, that, you know, things that we probably want to look at, but something that should have experience. Budget and stuff like that. That's what they're going to do too. So no, I think that's something that for one of our main, I guess, budget's obviously one of our main objectives, but I think our true main objective is to get a free person on board.
Yes.
So we can have free people on board and start making decisions and things. So between those two things, it's been our true main objective. And town administrator obviously is a big help too.
Right, and they do offer interim services,
which
so we want to get a temporary town administrator.
Mm-hmm.
They usually, they said it averages about $85 an hour, and a typical engagement is about 20 to 24 hours a week.
That's what I would say. It probably is on, part-time for maybe 2 or 3 weeks, 2 or 3 months.
I did get a response from him today about the timeline that it typically takes to bring somebody on board, to recruit and bring somebody on board, and he estimated about 90 days.
Wow. And that's obviously considering today's job market, right? About 30 days a year ago, 2 years ago, now it's 90, right?
Well, that and sometimes they're getting candidates that have to relocate as well, so they kind of factor that into the equation. So he did tell me that they recently had about 25 candidates in the Berwick recruitment effort. So there are definitely a pool of candidates around there.
So town of Berwick was looking for a town manager, and that's what they told you?
I think, is it a town administrator or a town manager?
Yeah, might be.
I can check that. And then he said, but in Deering, like locations like Deering, which is kind of really out there, they only have 6 candidates. So, you know, a lot of what they're seeing is sometimes it's military candidates who come in, retired military candidates, which is kind of good.
Yep. Yeah, I just was reading, I think I was sharing the last one, that the town of Berwick's going through something, that they want to come here to. And that, I think that would tough time in place of it. The one thing they stressed, and I have to agree, is it's important that whoever comes in can work with a long time employees, and it's a good effort.
Right.
Not the other way around.
So the good part about the temporary services that they don't have any expectations that there has to be a transition process. They basically just kind of jump in and don't need to come up to speed necessarily. Mm. So that was kind of interesting. And so as part of their packages, though, they do phone interviews, they do essay screens. So they do offer quite a bit of service.
Good.
So I think, you know, probably we should be prepared once we onboard the third selected person to kind of really deal with this.
And Lola, I think as soon as possible, we probably want to let's put that in our house, right? Good. Thanks for doing a lot of research. And they had, again, they had the pluses and minuses, in my opinion, with the chief, you know, a lot of pluses and minuses, but your job replacement could be reported.
Okay.
Cool.
So that's all I have.
Well, this is in the community board. Why is it always that non? Is it non-public that we're going to...
Actually, we've been talking about that too. It'll be a quick discussion.
Okay.
Is there any community input? And I want to apologize if you aren't hearing well, because we do not have the device that we usually use. Let me unmute and see if there is any. So if there's any community input, can you please raise your hand? So we're
going to
go into non-public, so can
we... So I'll make a motion for non-public for our city government area as a person.
Question? Yep.
Roll call vote.
Okay. Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. All in favor, aye.
Thanks. Aye.
Aye. So the camera stuff, don't understand that one, I'm sorry, right?